Hello, hello guys! Today I will show you how to build an infinite anvil station. So let's at first have a look at it. We got an anvil over here, and you know this problem in survival mode when you use anvils over and over again, they will get these cracks and sooner or later break down. So this anvil is pretty worn out already, it has the cracks, and if you would use it again, there's a chance that it might break and you would have to craft a new one. So, but this is an infinite anvil station, so yeah, we want to keep the anvil. So what we do when it's too broken, we just press this button once, and the anvil is refreshed. Now we could use it over and over again, till it has the cracks again. I will just replace it in creative mode here, and when it's at this point again, we just press a button, and there we go. The anvil is repaired. So let's have a look at it. It's fairly compact. We just have the redstone wire going up from the button over here with the redstone torches and triggering the dispenser and then a piston over here. Nothing too complicated. So I would say I will just start a tutorial on it now and after that explain how it roughly works. To start building, we place down an anvil. Behind this anvil, we place down 1, 2, 3 blocks. On the last block of the 3 blocks, we place a piston, and next, we just want to place 3 blocks on the left side up, and 3 blocks on the right side up. So from the front, it looks like this. Next, we will take iron bars and place them on top of the anvil and on the 2 side blocks. So 3 iron bars up here. On top of these iron bars, we place 3 blocks again, and there we go. Next, we want to go to the back side. Take a dispenser and now go in here and place the dispenser on the center block of the 3 blocks we just placed. It's important that it points downwards and there we go. Now it's like this. Now we want to take our blocks again. Place 1 block here, 1 block behind the dispenser. If you want to place it on the dispenser you have to press shift, keep that in mind, and 1 block back here. Also in between the 3 blocks we just placed, we place another block over here. And there we go. Now we can start with the redstone. So we go back to the front and start with a wooden button, or it also can be a stone button. We place it on the right side of the anvil, over here on this block. Then we go behind and place a redstone torch on the block where the button points in. On top of the block where the torch points in here, we place a second torch. Now we place 4 redstone on these 4 blocks, like this. Next, we want to place a repeater on top of the dispenser. It should be on 4 ticks delay. On the left side of it, we also place a repeater on 4 ticks delay, and in front of this repeater, a repeater with 3 ticks delay. So, back to the first repeater, we place a redstone in front, and go to the back side here, and place a redstone torch against the block we just placed the redstone on. Now, to finish it off, we just need to place a block next to the piston, redstone on top of that, block on top of that, so that the repeaters can power the redstone here and then the piston. And that's pretty much it already. Now we just need to start it up, so we need a cauldron and a lava bucket for that. We place the cauldron from the front against the sticky piston we used there, and then can place the lava bucket in there. Can just do that by going in here and pointing against this block. And there we go, the lava bucket is in. Now we couldn't use it because there are no arrows in the dispenser yet. So what we want to do is just access the dispenser. We can actually do that from over here if we look at this corner of the block. So we open the dispenser inventory, shift some arrows in. And there we go, that's it. If I now press a button, we see it resets the anvil. And yeah, if it would break down again, we can just repeat the process. So that's it. Before we get to how this machine works, I want to say thank you to JL real quick. He helped me to make this design as compact as it is. Thank you, JL. So, yeah, that's done. Let's get to the explanation. So, I'm in the snapshot at the moment. This machine also works in 1.7 and earlier versions. I'm just in the snapshot for a new feature. So, if I press F3, you can see 14W11B. But way more interesting is on the right side in the last row, you see block Minecraft cauldron /0. Now the interesting thing is the number at the end, the 0, that's the metadata of the block. So the metadata is used to describe different states of a block. For example, for a cauldron, it's how filled the cauldron is. So 0 is not filled at all, 1 is slightly filled, 2 is almost full, and 3 is completely full. Everything above that, so you can see in the top right corner, it's still block Minecraft cauldron, but with a metadata 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There would be more, but for what I want to show, that's enough. So for everything above the metadata, which you usually can get in the game, in the snapshots, it only renders this missing texture. So, but I still place these cauldrons because I want to show something with them. Now, at first, let's have a look at the anvils. I placed anvils next to it, again with the metadata 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can see for anvils the metadata tells the direction of the block, so 0 is this direction, 1 this one, 2 is actually a different direction than 1, but it looks almost the same, and it goes so on. At 4 we got a slightly damaged anvil in the same direction as 0. And that goes on for the next one, so slightly damaged in all directions. And then from 8 on, we got heavily damaged in all directions. Again, it would go on here, but from here on, it would just be a missing texture thing. So I left them out. So now I want to show you a feature with cauldrons, which we'll use. So if a burning entity gets inside a cauldron of water, it will get put out. And also, so this cauldron is the one with the two. Just remember that. Now I will ignite myself. Also, when I go in there, I will get put out. And you saw the metadata in the top right corner decreased from 2 to 1. Now we can do that again. It will decrease the metadata again. Now it's 0. So every time an entity gets put out in a cauldron, it will decrease the metadata by 1. Now another interesting thing is, with these invalid cauldrons, which you can get in the normal game, you also get put out. So these are basically overfilled anvils. They will just not only count one down, so let's do it with this one. That's 8, so you see the metadata in the top right corner is 8. If I jump into this one while I'm ignited, you can see it puts me out, but it doesn't jump down to 7 as we might expect. It actually jumps down to the next valid metadata, to the 3. So the same thing goes for all the other invalid metadatas here. It will all jump down to 3 as soon as an entity gets put out in them. Now, how do we use it to change the anvils? Let me just switch to creative mode. There we go. You can see the very damaged anvil over here has metadata 11. And we will use a trick I recently showed in Panda Survival as well, with arrows. So if we shoot an arrow in a block, it will remember the coordinates of the block it is stuck in. And if we now remove this block, it will keep remembering the coordinates and drop down. And yeah, we will place this cauldron again then. And when the arrow hits the anvil down here finally, it will look up the coordinates where it was stuck before and use this block for the calculations. So you see, I used the burning arrow there. Oh, now I picked it up. And yeah, a burning arrow also gets put out by cauldrons, just to show that. If I shoot a burning arrow at this cauldron with metadata 11, it gets put out and jumps down to 3. Now, if we do the same thing over here, and just let the arrow drop down, you can see it hits the anvil and resets it to metadata 3, because the arrow believes that the anvil is a cauldron. So here we go. Same for both sides. We could repeat it over here. Place a block there, shoot an arrow in. Well, over here it's just a cauldron, so we don't even need to place a block. So it just puts it down to 3. Now this anvil with metadata 10, we can do it as well. Shoot an arrow in, remove the block, place a cauldron before it hits, and it gets reset to 3. We could do that all the line down, till here. From here on it would count down by 1. But there's no need to count it further down than 3, because this anvil is already fully repaired. So that's how this works. Now there's more metadata changing possible with other things like pressure plates. Gannon has a video on that, so I will just redirect you to his video for that. Thanks for watching and see you next time.